In the last video, we talked about slope-intercept form. In this video, we're going to talk about point-slope form. And I'm going to start with a question. Find the equation of a line with a slope of 1/3 that passes through the point -2, 4. And what you should notice right away is that the point that's given is not the y-intercept. If we were given the y-intercept, this problem would basically be finished. We would just put it in that y equals mx plus b form, plug in our numbers, and we'd be done. However, we don't have the y-intercept in this case. We do have a slope in this case, but we do not have a y-intercept. So one thought would be, well, maybe we can plot the point, maybe we can graph the equation, and figure out from the graph what the y-intercept is. So here's your point, -2, 4. And if we count out a slope of 1/3, that's a rise of 1 and a run of 3, and so on. So there's your line, but you'll notice it's not totally clear what the y-intercept is. You might be able to figure it out, but in general, graphing every single line to figure out what the y-intercept is not going to be a technique we want to use. Instead, we're going to use a formula. This is the point-slope equation. Now, m is a familiar letter. That still represents the slope. Just like the slope-intercept equation, the y and the x are actually going to stay in the equation. But the x1 and the y1 in this equation represent the x and the y-coordinates of the given point. So all we really have to do is plug in all of our numbers. We have y minus y1 is the y-coordinate of the given point, which is 4. M is the slope, which is 1/3 in this case. X stays where it is, and x1 is the x-coordinate of the point we're given, which in this case happens to be -2. So I'm just going to plug in a -2 there. You'll notice there was a negative in the equation itself in two different places, and those have to stay. Okay, so now it comes down to simplification. X minus a negative number is just x plus a number. And what we'd really like to do at this point is we'd like to solve for y. We want to get y by itself because that's the form that we're most comfortable with. So let's do it. I'm going to distribute the 1/3 through the parentheses here. You'll notice that 1/3 times 2 is 2/3. Now to get y by itself, we just have to add 4 to both sides. And we'll get an equation that looks something like this. Of course, we can combine the 2/3 and the 4 using fractions. We just found a common denominator between the 2/3 and the 4 here. And now we can combine them, and then we're finished. Okay, that's it. We found the equation of the line that has a slope of 1/3 that passes through the point -2, 4. We like the equation of the line in slope-intercept form because now we can easily pick out the slope as 1/3 and the y-intercept is 14/3. Okay, that's all I have for you on this video. You'll do a lot more examples in class. I want to get you a video quiz real quick. It's the exact same problem, just with different numbers. And the numbers are even a little bit easier because you don't have to deal with fractions. So let's do it. Find the equation of a line with the slope of 2 that passes through the point -1, 7. All right, good luck. I'll see you in the next video.